Okay. Do we have the microphones up here that we need to have the microphones up here with?
Hold on, please.
Okay. Can you grab that one?
I'm gonna hold on to it.
Okay, you've got that? Okay. Hold on.
Those in front, can you hold mics, please?
Yes.
Somebody give me one.
Okay, are we good?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I'm gonna introduce Chief Peter Carey, P-E-T-E-R Carey, C-A-R-E-Y. He's the Chief of Police for the Colorado Springs Police Department. Chief Carey.
So, very, very difficult afternoon in Colorado Springs. My heart goes out to many of the victims here. At this point, I have as many questions as you do. We're still trying to figure out exactly what happened, who our victims are, and what we need to do from this point forward. I have some hurt police officers. They're at the hospital. That's where I'm heading to next. We'll give you some more information as soon as we know it. Thank you.
I would like to, at this time, introduce Mayor John Suthers, S-U-T-H-E-R-S. He is the mayor of the city of Colorado Springs.
The only thing I would add is that the perpetrator is in custody. The situation has been resolved. There's no continuing peril to the citizens of Colorado Springs. But there's a huge crime scene that has to be processed. We have to determine exactly how many victims there are, and we'll be reporting on that in the near future.
I might add that there's a lot of agencies that helped out this afternoon besides the Colorado Springs Police Department. We have federal authorities here, federal state resources, and this was, like I said, a very tough afternoon, but we had help from everybody in the community, in the region, and the state. Thank you.
I'd also like to, hold on one moment. I'd like to, if you guys can step back.
Yep.
Chief Chris Riley, R-I-L-E-Y, with the Colorado Springs Fire Department.
Well, good evening, everyone. Just to add to what Chief Carey said, it's been a very challenging afternoon. Fire, police resources, and law enforcement, public safety from all different levels throughout the area have worked very well together. We established unified command early on. But thankfully, the situation at this time has been resolved, but our hearts and our prayers go out to the family of the loved ones of the victims that were involved in today's event. So it's been a very difficult day, but our first responders performed very, very well, did an outstanding job. Thank you.
Okay.
Christopher Riley.
Do you have fatalities?
So at this point, the information that I can tell you is that we have 115 Colorado Springs Police Department resources here on scene, in addition to 8 victims advocates that are working with us through this situation. We have the El Paso County Sheriff's Office, the Federal Bureau of Investigations, the University of Colorado at Colorado Springs Police Department, the Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms Bureau, the Colorado Bureau of Investigations, and we also have regional explosive units here on scene. As I stated earlier, the individual brought some items into the building with him, and that we have to work with our EOD units, our explosive ordnance units, to make sure that none of those items are a further hazard to the people on scene. At that point then, we are going to have to treat this as a crime scene. We are going to have to go through, we are going to have to identify if there are any individuals on scene that are injured and have not been transported, or individuals on scene that are deceased. We do not have any numbers at this point. The only thing that I can tell you is that there were 11 people that were transported to local hospitals. Of those 11 people, 5 of them were police officers from various agencies that have responded today. I do not have any confirmation of fatalities at this point. Again, as I said, we're going to have to work through the scene because we are now treating it as a crime scene and investigating it. We did get an individual in custody at 4:52 p.m. in our time zone here. That individual has been transported away from the scene, and obviously we're going to start our investigation from there.
Can you walk us through those last
minutes? I need to... Questions at a time. Steve.
Question, was the suspect shot at all? Is he injured or was he at all shot?
I don't have information that he was shot.
Eric?
walk us through those last few moments, because you said earlier there was no communication with the suspect. Talk about
correct.
That
earlier there was no communication with the suspect. We did get officers inside of the building at the Planned Parenthood, and the officers were able to shout to the suspect and make communication with him. And at that point, they were able to get him to surrender, and he was taken into custody. I do not have an identity on the suspect. As I've explained before, this is going to be a complicated scene that is going to take hours, probably days, to process for us here. In addition to that, we are working through the state law that requires the sheriff's office to investigate whenever our officers are involved in a shooting. And since we know that some of our officers did fire shots, they will be investigating that portion of this scene. One moment, Steve.
Did this happen at Planned Parenthood? Do we have a motive yet? Was the man trying to?
We only just have the individual in custody within the last 15 minutes. So to even speculate on a motive would not be reasonable.
Is shelter in place lifted at the grocery store?
I'm sorry, Steve.
How many rescues did you guys perform?
You know, I don't have the numbers on that. I know that our officers acted with untold valor to make sure that individuals were safely taken out of the Planned Parenthood building. We also had officers that immediately responded to the surrounded businesses, and they made sure that people received any type of medical aid and they were safe in those surrounding businesses. This is still very much unfolding for us because we've moved from the active threat to people's lives stage, and now we are looking at doing our investigation. And those are the type of things that will come out as we do our investigation. Obviously, we do have some concern because investigation, and we will be working with our partners towards some type of prosecution for this. And that means that there are things that we can bring forward and the things that we can't bring forward as we work through the prosecution of this individual for the crimes that he committed today against our community.
Do you know what the weapon was?
Oh, one moment. Ms. Kirby is identifying.
Thank you very much. Have the people in the King Supers and the other surrounding businesses been allowed to come out?
We are working through the process of allowing those individuals out. Obviously, we have to make sure that there's no other items that would possess or present a threat to them as we remove them from those buildings.
Do we know how many people are in these lockdown buildings?
We don't. That's something that we're going to have to do as part of our after action and part of our report for the beginning.
Right there. Jesse?
Do you know how many, do you know what kind of weapons or weapon that the suspect was found with? Did he have? Can you talk about what kind of?
The only information I have is that the original information is that he had some type of a long firearm.
So the officers have made it into the building and they're now clearing the building?
The officers are
point.
Actively
so
clearing the building.
Does that mean the devices then that you were mentioning earlier have been rendered safe?
No, they have not. We don't know whether they're devices. Those are things that we are currently processing and that we're working through.
And are those the things that are in his car in the parking lot?
I'm not even sure if he has a car in the parking lot, sir. Those are things that we're working through.
The 11 folks who are transported to the hospital, how serious are their injuries?
On that.
Could you please look in the center of the crowd when we answer all questions?
Sorry, I don't have an update on the individuals that were transported or their status at this time. Okay.
Mayor Suthers, as a former Attorney General, as a former El Paso County DA, and now the Mayor of Colorado Springs, what would you say to the citizens about this sad day and about how exemplary law enforcement has been today?
Well, I spent a couple hours in the command center watching as the officers were monitoring movement within the building on security cameras and communicating to the officers who were in the building, and it was the most incredible work on behalf of officers trying to minimize the number of fatalities and get this guy in custody. And I was just incredibly impressed. This, while it's a terrible, terrible tragedy, the way the police handled this, I think, minimized or kept it from being even a worse tragedy.
Can you elaborate on some of those things that you thought really stood out?
The fact that they were able to identify where this person was on cameras and communicate to officers in the building where he was located.
You call it a tragedy. You're not yet willing to say whether there were fatalities or not?
No, I'm not. We need to figure out exactly what the nature of the victim's injuries are.
Okay, I would also like to introduce the district attorney for the 4th Judicial District, Dan May, and it's M-A-Y.
This is a horrible tragedy for our community. We saw a lot of individual acts of bravery today, and actually a lot of bravery as a team. It was amazing how law enforcement and first responders came together today, worked very well and efficiently today, but it still is a horrible tragedy. I will not be commenting on any of the facts at this time. The Colorado Springs Police Department is the lead agency, so Catherine Buckley would be responding to any facts. As we go through this process, certainly our office will be the lead prosecuting agency, and the case will be transferred over to us, and we will then be the lead agency, and it would be appropriate for us to respond to any factual questions at that time. I'm not going to get into specifics at this time. The Colorado Springs Police Department is the lead agency, and all facts and any information about the case should go through them. So the only thing that would be appropriate for me to comment on at this time is just the horrible tragedy for this community and the acts of bravery.
If you were, would you bring in the U.S. attorney, or would you handle it?
I think he already answered that question.
What hospital for all the victims transported to? Penrose?
Hold on just a moment.
Okay.
You had a question?
Are there still victims inside the building, or has everyone been transferred?
We are trying to ascertain whether we still have people inside the building. Once the suspect was taken out of the building, our process is to go through and clear the building room by room, and then we turn it into a crime scene and look at it from that standpoint.
Everyone was transported to Penrose, all 11 victims?
No.
How many rooms are they having to clear? How big a building is this?
This is a clinic.
Right, but how many rooms?
I'm not sure of how many actual rooms were inside the clinic, but I mean, you have treatment rooms, you have waiting rooms, you have offices, you have bathrooms, you have all sorts of different rooms because it is a medical clinic that provides medical services. So at this point, all further updates will either come from the Colorado Springs Police Department via the PIO office. One of the things that you could follow is at CSPD PIO for any type of updates or information, or they will come from the El Paso County Sheriff's Office in regards to this situation. We appreciate that you guys have been out here and that you have brought this information to the public to let them know to stay away from this scene. The streets are still going to be closed for a while until we make sure that everything has been rendered safe around the building. Thank you.